Hi everyone, Merry Christmas 2025. This video is still about iPhone 13 Pro Max widescreen repair. I know it's an outdated model, but I'm still getting this repair that someone already have applied the solution and it still doesn't work. So I'm gonna explain further in the video why you need to make another jump and why the jumper it works. Hello everyone, it's been a while. So today's case I have is 13 Pro Max widescreen problem, and someone already have fixed it before and it doesn't work, still widescreen. Let me check the wire and let's see under the microscope. I already have found the problem, so I can see the wire he make is good. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yes. Number 7 left, go to right number 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes. So this line should be working, but it's still widescreen. If you have such of a problem, you're going to measure the next dot. Okay. From the left, number 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This dot. And you're gonna measure it with multimeter if you don't have oscilloscope. And if your oscilloscope, it is better. You can tell why it doesn't work. Okay, so number 8 from the left side, I got 0.8, okay, 0.79. So let's go to the other side of here. Okay, I'm gonna measure this guy. I got 1.5, so a lot higher. So the voltage is high. If you touch here, you will feel there's a heat from the lower side of the screen. It's hot. I'm gonna show you with thermal camera. So if I flip it behind, I can see this side is hot. Okay, it is hot. 45 Celsius. Both sides. This is 42, 45. So, yep. So, I am going to measure with oscilloscope to give you an idea. If you want full explanation, you should join my online course. I have it on semester 3. I explain why the measurement from the multimeter cannot be trusted at all, okay, especially for this kind of line. Okay, so let's continue to measure it. Let's put the screen stay white by bringing up the power shutdown menu. Okay, I'm going to measure the good one first. Okay, left number 8 of here, so then you will have an idea. Okay, as you can see the waveform, what I want to tell you is if you measure with multimeter, you remember just now it was about like 0.8, like that. Actually is 6.6 volt, and then the minimum, the lowest point is actually minus 9.3 volt. So this is why I don't encourage you to measure with multimeter. Sometime when this offset, let's say the voltage it fall down is not that much and your multimeter cannot tell a little difference. Okay, maybe it's still showing you 0.9 something, you know. Okay, not much different. 0.9 in here, 0.8 in there. You don't see a problem. But if you measure with oscilloscope, you can tell, okay, do I have an exact waveform? Okay. So let's check another dot here. The screen is still on. See the current waveform. So you can tell it is running 3.5 volt as maximum, And when it fall down, it only fall into 1.8. And now it's 0.8. And it's not falling down. It should go off. It should drop to, you know, 9 point something, minus 9 point something. If I measure this guy here, you see, I'm running 6.6 volt minus 9.3. Okay, so that's a difference. Since these two dots that should be identical, I'm gonna apply the solution. Of course, I already have soldered it and I just want to make the video. Actually, I don't want to share at all. I just want to make it exclusive to my student only. But okay, since this model is quite old, it's time to share it. Okay, so make the jump here. Come back to here. Right. Okay, let's measure it. Yeah, it should be identical now. Yep. And the temperature of here, it is not that warm anymore. It's cold now. So, checking with thermal camera, I don't see the heat anymore. Okay, and I put my finger beside the screen. You see, my finger is actually hotter than the screen. Okay. So when the screen is running, we shouldn't have any heat on the lower side of here. Okay. Our finger should be almost the same temperature as the screen, or maybe the screen is lower than us. It's not that hot, not like 45 Celsius. So, yep, that's it for the sharing. Okay, I already told you another dot that could be your problem. As for the first jumper, it might not be the problem. You can disconnect it. Okay, you can make the second. Again, number 8 from the left, going number 9 from the right. Okay, second row. Yep, that's it for the sharing. This is the 100% solution, bro. Never listen to this kind of instruction. Even I already told you the solution, you still need to measure it first before you apply. Okay, I'm really tired to see this kind of comment everywhere. There are many resources. You just look at them as a direction and to check whether you have unusual or same symptoms. So from this point, you already understand those lines not linear voltage because it is OLED screen, not LCD anymore. So many lines that are supposed to be blinking like that way, on off, they have a negative voltage. Very fast, and that's the reason I don't encourage you to use multimeter compare the reading from some other resource. Okay, you should only compare with yourself unless you guys have a same multimeter. Of course, it will be better if you have oscilloscope. Just look at the waveform. Okay, some lines they're supposed to be do the stuff like PWM. I think you can Google this word if you don't understand what is this for. So this is why when the screen become whole white, or maybe a whole yellow, whole green, we will suspect maybe one of the line is not blinking anymore. It has become a linear voltage. And then the second symptom, it would be a little hot below there. And as for the 13 Pro Max, the left side, it should be the yellow and the green. The right side, it should be the white. So when you have a white screen problem, you just check the right side of the dot. I believe there are so many resource solution all over in the internet.
I think you just look at them and then you compare with your screen. Yeah, you better make your own database. So my online course is always to unlock your brain, like this, exactly. I'm explaining a really simple things, something like this, okay? This dot 0.8 will, this dot 1.3. You make the bridge, you make the jump. Why? This dot is not become 1.3. It should be, because there's a lot of explanation. If you have a very strong basic, even these kind of things, you already know it. So I guess that's it for the video. Consider this as a Merry Christmas present. And I see you in the next video. Bye.